regular sports, I think there's no problem for the school to allow them to carry guns in case that a bad guy tried to come into school to do something bad to the kids. That security officer would be able to stop the bad guy from coming in. But for a teacher to carry, I'm totally against it, because the teacher has a direct relationship with the children. Sometimes the teacher may have a conversation with the student, and the student is mad. And we can see on Facebook there's a lot of fighting between teachers, altercation between teacher and student.
So the teacher could potentially use that firearm in a bad.
The teacher might be mad if the student punch or fight the teacher. The teacher will take to pull the gun and kill the student that he or she was supposed to protect. So I would not agree for a teacher to carry guns in school or in the classroom, but for a police officer or security guard who's been trained to be in the army or police force, I think it's okay to allow them to carry.
Excellent. Thought from the audience.
I agree with the ambassador, and I think that kind of bridges into your question about how to bridge the gap between people, police, and the things like that. I feel like it's not a good idea to place that kind of figure amongst kids. I feel like it's a, I won't say a scare tactic, but to put that kind of intimidation around kids, it furthers the disconnect between people and authority figures, just like in terms of police and neighborhoods. If children are, you know, seeing people with weapons, that's intimidation, something they're afraid of, right? Same thing with police in certain neighborhoods. You have police that don't really come from the places that they tend to be policing, and so the conversation and the interaction is not one of positive and one of comfort. It's a scare, it's uncomfortable, it's not something that, you know, you kind of want to deal with. You see police, you want to avoid them because, you know, to your knowledge, things don't always go well. So I don't think that the way to do that is to put an intimidation factor in those kind of environments. There's too
understood.
Much comfort
in that. I understand your point. Any other points regarding guns in schools? No. Okay. If that's not it, we're going to go into a 3-minute portion for our panelists, because we're going to be closing out, and they could just speak freely on whatever issues they think could fill the bridges between our community, our criminal justice system, reform, and the police.
Okay, I'm going to go first. There's a lot of people out there who say cops is bad. Everybody hates cops. I doubt 100% that everybody hates cops. There are many people out there who loves cops. And cops or law enforcement are like your father. So they're here to protect you. If you're doing something wrong, so you know, they will do the best for them to correct you. Now, if you're a bad person, if you're driving without a license, you're not going to like cops. If you driving with no car insurance, of course, you're going to fear the cops. But if you're doing good, you know, you have a license, you're not speeding, you do not drink and drive, so there is no reason to hate cops. If the cops, the reason that there's always altercation between a police officer and someone is because they refuse to follow law. If a police officer pulled you over and you speed, you're speeding, you know they're not going to let you get away. They're going to follow you. And what you do not understand is that when you try to run away from the cops, you know, all they have to do is to use the walkie-talkie and have backup, have somebody to catch you 2-3 blocks ahead. So there's no way you can't get away from cops. So cops, they're not bad. Not everybody hates cops. They're here to protect you. They're here to secure the community. But if you do not respect law, you violate the law, so you, of course, you're going to have altercation. Of course, you're going to have problems with cops. Of course, when you see a police officer, You know, you're going to get mad. You're going to say, oh my God, I gotta be one of them. But if you're doing what you're supposed to do, I think there should be no problem between the community and the cops. What you're doing right now is going to build a bridge between the community and the police officers to bring them together, have panel like police officer, law enforcement, to speak to the churches, to speak to the student, to let them understand that they are not here to hurt you. They are here to protect the community, to help you, but you need to cooperate. Of course, we may host events like this. We may host game, basketball game stuff. But yeah, if you still violate the law, you're still going to get in trouble with the cops. Of course, if you host Black Party, the cops will know who's who, who's leaving the block.
Community
policy. However, even though you host those events, if later on you're doing something bad, you're killing somebody, or you're driving without a license, or you're doing something wrong, the cop still going to arrest you, going to stop you. So the best way to build the bridge between cops and the community is for us, the community, to follow and respect the law. Because the cops are there to make sure they enforce the law.
Thank you, Ambassador. Carl, thank you for hosting this. Thank you for everybody for coming out tonight in this horrible weather. I think that these conversations are extremely important. As you can see, as Carl pointed out, not everyone on the panel agreed on every issue, but it's important, especially on issues that we might disagree with, to have these conversations. If everybody in the room was saying the same thing, then this wouldn't be important. I look forward to this being the first of many conversations like this. Right now, as Carl is a candidate for office, he mentioned before, but when he does get elected on June 24th, right?
26th,
sorry.
Thank you.
As your congressman here in the 5th District, that I look forward to many more of these conversations with the community and enjoying this dialogue that's very necessary. So thank you and thank my fellow panelists.
Thank you.
So I concur. I think it's great that you have this approach. And really what I would urge when you get elected is that we appropriate funds for education to improve the sporting activities, the basketball courts, football fields. You know, I hate to be so simple, but you know, I'm gonna just give you my relationship as a doctor for 38 years. If I were to just treat someone and never educate them on how to brush, how to take care of themselves, how to eat the right food, they're gonna get sick again. If I just wanted to make money off of them and didn't care, that's what I would do. But in reality, what we have to take a look at is just really is when people are productive, people are happy. When people have a future and a hope, then the community here that you'll be representing will improve, the economy will improve, and so will the New York City economy improve. I don't really think that, I know we had a discussion about this, I don't see drugs as the answer because of what I've seen over the years as they increased and all the violence and the things that are wrong and the need for police and the shootings we've had. But the point is not to concentrate on that, the point is to concentrate how to go positive. Education, community activities like you're having today, sporting activities, cultural activities, dance. These are the things that have already been decided by groups like the United Nations. So I definitely know, because I've met you, I've seen how you are, that you're gonna bring that out in the community, and that it will change the community, and I can't wait to see you when you get elected.
Thank you, Dr. Dixon. Thank you.
I think we all agree that education is part of it, and that we go not just for young people, but for example, for police, and all of us, really. So I would say that's That's one objective.